concept, divisibility test. So what is the concept? Divisibility test for a number. For example, see, this is divisibility rule for 2. Then next I wrote divisibility rule for 3. Clear? So similarly we can write 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Clear? So we have to see the rule for divisibility rule for 2, 3, 4, etc. Okay? Now, if I consider any small number, the example, for example, if you get any small number, for example, 2 or 20, okay? So this number, isn't it, we can say which number will divide 20, which table divides 20, isn't it? So 2 divides 20, you know, next 4 divides 20, 5 divides 20, then 10 divides 20, even 20 also divides 20, right? So suppose if you get large number, 2000, 50, so like this, this is 2 lakh 54. So can you say which table divides 2 lakh 54? So difficult to find, isn't it? You have to divide, it will take more time. It will take time to solve this. So easily we can find the answer by using this rule. See, divisibility rule of 2 says that if it ends with a number like 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8, means, see the number, here I consider for example 1520. 1520, in this number, the last digit, see the last digit, that is 0. So, the last digit is a 0, so we can say that 1520 is divisible by 2 table. Yeah? So, 2 divides this number. Why? Because the last digit is a 0. So, what is the rule? If it ends with a number, if it ends with a number 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8, okay? This the last digit, if you get these numbers, see in the second example, 124, so last digit is here, 4. So we can say that 2 divides 124, okay? In the next example, third example, see, 27,462, see the last digit, last number is 2, so if you get in the last table, then we can say that this number is divisible by 2 table. Clear? Otherwise, you have to divide like this. You have to check whether the given number is divisible by 2 or not. We will check 27,462 divisible by 2 table. You have to divide by long division. You have to divide step by step, right? But without doing this division, without doing this method, directly we can find the answer using this rule, divisibility rule. Clear? So how to identify? See, divisibility rule of 2 says that if it ends with a number 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8, last number, last digit should be 0 or 2 or 4 or 6 or 8. So here in this example, see, last digit is a 0. So we can say that this number is divisible by 2. If I consider another number 52,999. Okay? 52,999. Can you say that this number is divisible by 2? See the last digit is here 9. So this number is not divisible by 2. Because the rule says that if it ends with the number 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8, but in this example the last digit is here 9. So this number is not divisible by 2. Clear? Next up, divisibility rule for 3. Divisibility rule of 3. So now see, when we can say the number is divisible by 3. If you get small number, we can say, for example, if you get 27, we can say in 8 table. So 27 completely divides, right? 3 divides 27. If you get number 27, then you can say 27 is divisible by 3 table. In case if you get large numbers, like this 2079, can you say without doing number is divisible by the 3 or not? No. So what is the rule? We can say, you must know the rule. See, what is the rule? You have to apply this rule. Means the addition of number must be divisible by 3. Addition of number must be divisible by 3. So you have to find the sum of this number. Sum means addition, right? You have to find the sum. So now 2079, see our one example is given. 2079, you have to find out, you have to check whether this number divisible by 3 or not. How we can check? Without doing long division method, directly we can find the answer. Let me see. 2 plus 0 plus 7 plus 9. Okay? Add all the numbers or the digits. Means 2 plus 0 plus 7 plus 9. Okay? Now, if you add, you get 2 plus 0, that is 2. 2 plus 0, 2. 2 plus 7, 2 plus 7, 9. 9 plus 9, that is 18, correct? 9 plus 9, 18. So now, can you say that whether 3 divides 18? Yes, 3 divides 18. Therefore, we can say that 2079 is divisible by 3 table. 2079 is divisible by 3 table. Divisible by 3. Why? Because the sum of this number, we get 18. 18 is a multiple of 3. Correct? 18 is a multiple of 3. 18 is a 3 table, right? So we can say that this number also divisible by 3. How to check? No, you must know this rule. See, the addition of number must be divisible by 3. If addition of the number is divisible by 3, then we can say that the given number definitely will divide, right? So, second example is here, 1324 means 1324. So, 1324, first word or add all the numbers, all the digits. 1 plus 3 plus 2 plus 4. First add all these numbers. So what will get answer? 1 plus 3, 4. 4 plus 2, 6. 6 plus 4, we get 10. So now see the number. The answer we got 10. Now you have to see whether 10 is a multiple of 3. Is it 10 is a multiple of 3? No. 3 does not divide 10. Isn't it? We cannot see 10 in 3 table. So we can say that this number is not divisible by 3. Clear? So this number is not divisible by 3. Because why this is not divisible by 3? Because adding 5 sum of this number, we get answer 10. So 10 is not a multiple of 3. Clear? 10 is not a multiple of 3. So we can say that 1324 is not divisible by 3 table. So this is an easy method to find identify the given number is divisible by 3 or not. Clear?
Yes.
So this is a procedure. Thank you. Okay, next up, see divisibility rule of 4. Divisibility rule of 4. See here, the last two digits must divisible by 4. The last two digit must divisible by 4. If you get last two digits must divisible by 4. Means for example here 4624. 4624. In this example, this is the last two digit. If that number is divisible by 4, then we can say that this number is divides. Clear? So see here, the last digit is here 24. Last two digits are 24. You know 24 is divisible by 4 table. 24 divisible by which table? 4 table. Correct? 4 hours are 24. 4 6 are 24. So we can say that this 4624 is divisible by 4 table. Clear? So next examples here. This is 5,25,020. 5 lakh division method, we can find directly, we can find the answer, we can identify the given number divisible by 4 or not. Okay, how to check? Divisibility rule of 4 says that the last two digits, the last two digits must be divisible by 4. See the last two digits, that is your 20, correct? Last two digits is 20. See that 20 is divisible by 4? Yes, 4 divides the 20. 4 is 20, 5 is 20. So we can say that this given example, this number is divisible by 4. Because the last two digits are divisible by 4. So we can say that this 5,25,000 or 20 are divisible by 4. Okay. So next up, see here 39,326. 39,326. Whether this number is divisible by 4 or not. Can you say? See the last number is here 26. Last two digit is 26. Is it 4 divides 26? Whether 4 divides 26? No. 4 does not divide 26. So we can say that this 39,326 is not divisible by 4 table. Clear? It's not divisible by 4. Okay? Next rule, divisibility rule of 5. Divisibility rule of 5, what is that? The number must ends by 0 or 5. The number must ends by 0 or 5. So go to see the last digit. If last digit is 0 or it may be 5, then we can say that the given number is divisible by 5. Clear? The given number is divisible by 5. Well, okay? Now see your example. 22,500. 22,500. If this last digit is 0, right? Last digit is 0, then we can say that 22,500. This number is divisible by 5. Well, this number is divisible by 5. Clear? So next example, 3,245. 3,245. See the last digit here. The last divisibility rule of 5 says that ends, the last number ends with a 0 or 5. Okay? So here also see the example. 3,245. Last digit is your 5. So we can say that this number is divisible by 5. Clear? Now last see the more divisibility rule of 6. What is the rule says that if it is divisible by 2 and by 3 table. If it is divisible by 2 and by 3. See now example 27972 means 27,972. So this number is divisible by 6 or not. The rule says that if the given number is divisible by 2 and by 3, should divide both by 2 and by 3. If just divisible by 2 means not a, it will not divisible by 6. So you have to check both 2 and 3. The given number must be divisible by 2 and must be divisible by 3. Then we can say that the given number is divisible by 6. Clear? So first we check divisibility. This 27,972 is divisible by 2 table. Why? Because the last digit is here 2. Correct? The last number, last digit is 2. We know that 2 divides. Last digit is 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8, then 2 divides, right? So in this number, last digit is here 2, so 27,972 divisible by 2 table. Next you have to check whether the same number is divisible by 3 or not. So now check 2 plus 7, you know divisibility rule of 3. You add all the numbers, 2 plus 7 plus 9 plus 7 plus 2. So what happens if we add all the numbers? say 2 plus 7, that is 9. 2 plus 7, 9. 9 plus 9, 18. 18 plus 2, 20. 20 plus 7, 27. Correct? 2 plus 7, 9. 9 plus 9, 18. 18 plus 2, 20. 20 plus 7, 27. So 27 is a multiple of 3, right? 27 is a multiple of 3. So 3 divides 27. 3 divides 27. So this number is divisible by both 2 and 3. So 27,972 is divisible by 2 and 3. So therefore, we can say that the number is divisible by 6. Yeah? The number is divisible by 6 because 2 and 3 table divides that number. So 6 also divides the same number. Clear? Thank you. Okay, next up, divisibility of 8. Divisibility of 7 is not very negligible. Next, divisibility rule of 8. So, if the last 3 digits of whole number are divisible by 8, if the last 3 digits of a whole number are divisible by 8, then we can say that the given number is divisible by 8. Yeah. So first you have to see an example. 1792 is divisible by 8 or not. How to check? See, you have to see the last 3 digits. If last 3 digits is divisible by 8, then the given full number is divisible by 8. Okay, now last digit is 792, correct? 792 is divisible by 8 or not. First you have to check last 3. Last 3 digits are 792. So now first divide 8, how much are 79. Okay, how much are 79? 8 9 are 72, right? 8 9 are 72. What is remaining here? Again, 72. 8 9 are 72. So answer will be 0. So it divides exactly. So we can say that 1792 is divisible by 8. Yeah, it is divisible by 8 table. Clear? Yes, next example you can take. See here, one more example, 2880. This also you can check. Last digit is 818. So that this number is divisible by 8 or not. So now, 8 ones are 8. So remainder is 0, 0. 8 ones are 0, 8 zeros are 0. So remainder is 0. So we can say that 880 is divisible by 8. So 2880 is divisible by 8 table. Clear? So this number is divisible by 8. So to check, first you have to see last three digits is divisible by 8 or not. Yeah. So if last 3 digits are divisible by 8, then we can say that the entire number is divisible by 8. Okay. Next up, divisibility rule of 9. Divisibility rule of 9. The rule says that if the sum of the digits, if the sum of the digits are multiples of 9. If the sum of the digits are multiple of 9. Multiple of 9, no multiple of 9. So, what are the multiples of 9? 9, 18, 27, 36, so it should be right? 45, 63, all must have multiples of 9. So, you should get, if you add any numbers, any digits, these numbers, if you add, you should get multiples of 9. If you get multiples of 9, then it definitely divides, right? Yes, now we'll see. The given example is 51,984. 51,984. First, you add and see. 5 plus 1 plus 9 plus 8 plus 4. So if you add, we get 5 plus 1 6. 6 plus 9 15. 15 plus 8 23. Correct. 23 plus 4, we get the 27. Here we get answer 27. So 27 is a multiple of 9, right? 9 numbers are 27. 9 threes are 27. So we can say that the given number is divisible by 9. Clear? How we can check? First you have to see same rule for 3 also, right? So you have to apply the same rule here. 5 plus 1 plus 9 plus 8 plus 4 means you have to find sum of this number, sum, addition, right? So first add all this number, we get one answer. That answer, if it is a multiple of 9, then we can say that 9 divides this number. Clear? Same rule for 3 and 9. Okay? Explain again. Divisibility rule of 9 and 8. Thank you. Okay, next rule. Divisibility rule of 10. Divisibility rule of 10. See here. If the last digit is 0, then we can say that the given number is divisible by 10. Clear? The given number is divisible by 10. How we can check? You have to see the last digit. If last digit is 0, then we can say that the number is divisible by 10. Clear? So here the given number is 2,05,000, right? 2,05,000. So in this last digit is 0, so this number is divisible by 10. So another example, here I considered 7 lakh. 7 lakh, last digit is 0, so this number also divisible by 10 table. Clear? So it is divisible by 10. Understood? So last digit must be 0. Next, now divisibility rule by 11, or divisibility rule of 11. So this is very important. So here, take the alternating sum of the digits. Take the alternating sum of the digits in the number. Read from left to right. You read from left to right. Yeah. So this is what? Take the alternating sum of the digits in the number. Read from left to right. So that means, see here, I consider the number, that is 2728. Okay. 2728. So this you have to check whether the given number is divisible by 11 or not. So how to check? The rule is, says that, see, take the alternating sum. Take the alternating sum of the digits in the number. Read from left to right. Read from left to right. Clear? That means you write it is 2 minus 7. Clear? 2 minus 7 plus 2 minus 8. Okay? Write 2 minus 7 plus 2 minus 8. So this you have to find the answer. First, you know how to add integers. See here, the sign is plus. Can consider like it. Plus 2 minus 7. Plus 2 minus 7. We get answer minus 5. Okay? Plus 2 minus 7. Answer is minus 5. Next number is plus 2, right? So now simplify this. Minus, so this minus 5 plus 2. Minus 5 plus 2, we get answer minus 3. Why? Because here different sign, subtraction. Different sign, subtraction, same sign, addition. Then you have to see the greater number sign, correct? So now minus 5 plus 2, this greater number is minus 5, right? So minus 3. Different sign, subtraction. 5 minus 2 is 3. So greater number sign is minus. So answer is a minus 3. So remaining one number, that is minus 8. We'll write in the next step. So minus 3 minus 8, we get answer minus 11. Correct? Same sign, addition. sign is a greater number sign, that is minus. Correct? So answer is a minus 11. So minus 11 is the answer of 2728. Correct? So now you can see that this number minus 11 is divisible by 11. Yes. We know that 11 divides 11. Correct? 11 ones are 11. So 11 divides the 11. So we can say that this number means 2728 is divisible by 11 table. Clear? So why? Because after seeing this sum of alternating sum of the digits in the number, you read from left to right, you get answer minus 11. Minus 11 is divisible by 11. So we can say that this number 2728 is divisible by 11 table. Clear? So this is the rule for 11. Clear?
Yes.
Thank you.